having memorable games in a row. That's my first target. That people really want to see the next game. You leave the stadium and want to see the next game. You can't wait for the next game. That's what football should be. And if you can do this very often, then you will be successful 100%.
The directors or the head of my school, when I did the A level, and I won a sports prize. Yeah? So my best friends won the science prize and language prize, and I got a sports prize. Funny. So and then he said in front of all these other guys who got A level that night, with a mic in his hand, I hope it works out with football, because if not, I'm really worrying about you.
So, God help you.
And I thought, okay, I think the same, but why do you have to say that now in this, that everybody can hear it? So I knew I was lucky. Oh, be open. Just be open and learn language as quick as possible. That helps a lot. So and the nice thing with English people is that they know it. They don't speak pretty much any foreign language because they don't have to. The whole world is speaking English, so why should you learn a foreign language? For us, we are always a bit in English, but they are not a lot in German. But what they are what's really nice is if you speak three words English, an English person makes a sentence of it. So they want to understand you. It's really like, ah, yeah, I know what you mean. And then they help you. So, but still, it helps a lot if you learn the language. It always helps with socializing and coming together. So it's brilliant. But apart from that, just be open and really learn. And learn is maybe for young people especially sounds like a negative word because it means like reading a book or whatever. But it's learning. It's actually learning from life, how they are, why they are like this. So it's, for me, it's really true. Since I'm in England, a year and a half ago, I stopped drinking coffee. If you would have asked me 2 years ago, you want a tea? I said, I'm not ill. Sorry, I don't need it. So, and but it's a nice tradition. It's a different ceremony to make it, and it's all a little bit different. Coffee is a machine, and I still can understand why people drink coffee. I had no coffee since 1.5 years, so for different reasons. But that's only one little thing. So I understand it why people are doing it here. They have tea time. They call. Dinner, they call it for tea. So it makes no sense, but it's just, what did you have for tea? And he said, for tea, nothing, we had no tea, but it's dinner. So they call it tea. And it's all so little things what you only understand really when you live there, because you don't find it in any books. Life is very often this kind of marketing. You have to be your own marketing business, like you have to sell yourself, stuff like that. That means you have to prepare for things like a press conference or whatever. I wasn't. So the only thing I know about myself is really that I can react pretty spontaneous. So because my life is my preparation for what, as long as I talk about football, I'm always prepared because I think so much about it, it's strange. And at press conference, my only worry was that my English will be good enough. So because of course I had no real English skills apart from I'm not the generation growing up with, okay, we could have heard a lot of music and learning English by that, like my sons did actually, but I was not that music guy, so my English was kind of.
Don't want to describe myself. The only thing I can say, maybe I ask, does anybody in this room think that I can do wonder? No, so let me work. I'm a totally normal guy. I came from Black Forest. My mother maybe sit in front of the television and watch this press conference, understand no word until now. So, but she's very proud. She's very proud. So I'm a totally normal guy. I'm the normal one, maybe, if you want this.
I said what I said. I was not prepared. I said I'm the normal one. And that's how I see myself. That's not... I don't know how to say it in English, but it's not that I want people to think, he says he's a normal one, but he knows he's a special one or whatever. That's not like this. I'm completely, because I think about myself as a completely normal person. I have so many questions still, much more than answers. Means could I be special? How could I be exceptional? So I know a little bit more about football than, yeah, some other people, that's true. That doesn't make me a special person. It gives only luck, because 500 years ago with that, I would have slept in the street. So with that knowledge. And I'm a really lucky person that my best skill is needed somehow out there. And that's what I appreciate every single day. I know hockey coaches, I work a lot. They work 5 times more than I do and earn 4%. Of what I earn. So if I'm not a happy person, it would be really crazy. But I'm smart enough not to overestimate that, not to think, oh, that's like that, because it's strange. It's just football. I have another skill, and that's, and again, pure luck. I can speak like a waterfall. So, and don't, I'm not worrying about what people think. That's true.
That's true. That's
so I'm not, yeah, absolutely. It's a pure gift. I know that. So it's a red light and camera. I'm not getting nervous. So that keeps me completely calm in a situation where 90% out there get nervous. That makes me different. It's a pure coincidence and a pure skill. I have nothing. I didn't teach myself in that. I didn't try to get it hard that it will be like this. Completely not. It's a pure talent. So how could I be proud on a talent? Yeah. So, but in the world out there where the outside view on you is really important, it's an important skill. Obviously, it's an important skill. But again, pure coincidence. 500 years ago, I could have danced in front of the king, probably. Yeah, that's it. And all the rest, and then I had again to sleep again in the street. So I know
so
that.
So you're a lucky guy.
100%. I said it a couple of times, but it's really like that. If you sign a player, you have to know as much as possible. It's easy to find a good football player, to know him as a person, or learning about him as a person. It's not that easy. That needs obviously experience, and I try that. Players are very often surprised when I meet them first time that we don't talk at all about football, because that thing is already done for me, because we only sit here because he's a very good footballer. Otherwise, it would be a waste of time. I should have met a not good footballer, to be honest, and ask him about our club or whatever. So, yeah.
So what are you talking with him then?
Life
in general.
Yeah, God and the good world.
God as well.
Possible.
Yeah.
That's possible. Yeah, but not really likely, to be honest. Everybody knows probably. Meanwhile, I'm Christian, I don't know.
A Bekehrer.
No, I'm not that. So I'm not a missionary or whatever. That's how it is. So people, we live in a free world, and we cannot. It's not my mission. I still use my interest for people. So I was always very interested in people. So that didn't change. The problems of the boys changed a lot because of social media and stuff like that. Much more pressure. When more money is involved, the pressure increase incredibly. Yeah? So and that's all. They are very young. But they are judged every day. It's like acting constantly in a glass house, constantly, because everyone sees you, whatever you do, each mistake, each failure, each good thing, each bad thing. The world out there is, if you are good, you are outstanding. If you are not good, you are the worst in the world. So there's nothing, there's only black, white, there's no gray. The color gray is disappeared somehow. And I was always a pretty calm person. That's probably, nobody can really imagine that, because I look quite different when I'm involved in a football game, that's true. But in normal things of life, I'm completely calm. And now, meanwhile, I'm much more experienced than I was that time. But I said, probably we spoke about that, I'm not sure, years ago, but because I was a very young father, I had to learn it pretty early to take care for younger people. And I learned that, and that's what I'm still doing. The boys are now younger than my sons are, so I still like it a lot, and so that's it. And in that job now, there are only players with world-class potential. Not all of them will be world-class, but have world-class potential, and my job is to help them to become really world-class. And that's the job to do, and that's not, they know already 80% about football, but the last 20% can be really decisive, and that's my job.